is continuing to see gains today. It's up 1.6% after that 4.4% gain yesterday. It's at 18 pesos and 32 centavos a share. This as investors again cheer prospects of the Padcal mine opening ahead of schedule. Now, time now for our company call this morning. We are joined by the president of GT Capital, Mr. Carmelo Bautista. Good morning, sir.
Morning, Warren.
Thank you for joining us this morning.
A pleasure.
Always and it's been a great year for you guys. You've been raising a lot of money for the T family. The IPO, you raised 24 billion just last year, really the hallmark of why so much money was raised here at the PSC, yeah. Why they're claiming that, you know, things are doing so well now. And then just the last week you had an overnight share sale of 14.3 billion pesos.
Yes.
Lots of money, and you're also considering an 8 billion peso bond sale up to 10 billion.
That's correct.
Where's all that money going to?
Well, the IPO was predominantly for the consolidation. It's mm-hmm. consolidation exercise, so shifting the non-bank, non-financial services assets into GT Capital. Mm-hmm. Also, we're in very capital-intensive sectors. Power generation, property development are very capital-intensive. Mm-hmm. So, and also the acquisition of Toyota, the top-up exercise was really to fund predominantly the Toyota acquisition, which we disclosed as earlier. In terms of the bond, yes, we are planning to go to the market to raise a potential 8 billion, upsize 10 if possible, to raise additional funds for the capex into the power and some refinancing of existing debt.
Okay, interesting to note though, the 14.3 billion peso overnight sale, this was really focused on foreign investors.
That's correct.
And then when we asked some brokers about this, they were a bit upset because they were thinking you sold the shares at 620 pesos a piece. That was a considerable discount from the doing price. It was like a 670 or 680 at that
7.7%,
time.
7.7%, yeah.
They were kind of upset that you didn't give them the opportunity.
Well, but the profile of the overseas buyers are desirable in the sense that these are long hold players. They are the large, so most of them are sovereign wealth funds, long-term hold players, and desirable for us, particularly since we're a long-term play type of company, no? and capital intensive type of requirements.
Yeah, and well, it looks like they weren't upset for too long. The price has actually recovered already.
Yes.
Right now it's at 680 pesos a share, doing very well today, up 2% so far.
Yes.
Let's talk a bit about your consolidation now. When you look at your 9-month earnings,
yes,
for last year, you,
yes,
see a huge jump in your revenues and your profits, 107% for your profits,
yes,
and for revenues, 211%. But that's,
yes,
mostly because you're in the process of consolidating all your businesses.
It's
together.
Both. It's both. It's consolidation as well as core growth in the sectors. Automobile sales are at a historical high. We're seeing, in fact, we're in uncharted territory in terms of volume sales are concerned for auto sales. We're looking forward to 2013, this year being an election year, we anticipate more growth in terms of volume sales because historically, election years always show some growth in terms of volume. And also in terms, going back to the top up, I think it was a function of timing. Raising or accessing capital markets is really as a function of timing. So while the rest of the world was celebrating Christmas and New Year, we were quietly preparing for the top up. Mm-hmm. And we wanted to be first out of the gate in the new year and able to tap the market at the very start.
Yeah, a lot of the foreign brokerages are expressing so much interest in the Philippines. You're seeing us in a sweet spot. And yeah, it's great to take advantage of all the interest right now,
yes,
in the Philippine economy. Moving again to your expectations for 2013, you mentioned that for your automobile service, you're expecting an increase,
yes,
in sales.
Yes.
We were talking off camera earlier, Mr. Bautista was saying that actually the candidates spend a lot on logistics vehicles.
Yes,
yeah,
yes.
Yeah, yeah. But where else are you expecting the election spending to help boost your businesses? Of course, your core businesses, banking, cars, real estate, insurance, and power.
Well, not directly. Indirectly, you'll see some increase in terms of, I guess, activity on the real estate side, as you see more spending on the local government side. In terms of growth, we anticipate continued growth in terms of reservation sales for property. Federal Land launched 12 projects last year. It will be launching another 12 projects this year. Core growth in terms of reservation sales are showing a 40% growth, very strong. Federal Land is positioned in the mid-priced segment, no? 5 to 10 million peso pricing points, which we feel are the strongest component of that sector, no? Sustainable.
Sustainable. You know, some of the foreign brokerages for foreign banks have warned that there is a chance of overheating.
Yes.
In terms of our asset prices. They warned that, you know what, maybe a consumer demand might push prices upwards. Are you guys worried about, or are you seeing any signs of possibly asset prices being artificially pushed up, especially in real estate?
Yeah, well, as far as the mid-price segment is concerned, we're very comfortable that these are end users, not speculators. These are first-time homeowners, which access bank financing and have the documentation to access bank financing. It's interesting that we are now at historical lows, no? Historical lows as far as interest rates are concerned, and that creates a different access to the product. Also, the demographic profile, you have more dual income families now, so the capacity to earn and save is there, and we're quite comfortable that's sustainable into the medium term.
Okay, and then moving on to power now. Of course, you are in the south, and that's the place where they actually need more capacity.
Yeah.
You're looking into expanding some of your plants. Tell us a bit about that.
Well, the Visayan grid continues to be the fastest growing grid. No? It's growing at around 5% per annum, and it takes, what, almost 3 years to build a plant, finish and complete the plant. So we're making the necessary investments ahead of time in anticipation of the future demand 2.5-3 years down the road. No? So we'd like to continue making these major investments. These are very capital intensive investments. Mm-hmm. We're expanding the Cebu plant in Toledo, and we're also expanding the Panay plant. No?
Okay, so all in all, you've been talking a lot about your capital expenditures this year. How much are you going to be spending this year compared to last year?
We're looking at a total capex of approximately close to 40 billion pesos this year. Mm-hmm. And that's mostly going to power and property.
Okay, when everything's said and done, which of your core businesses do you think will be the main driver of GD Capital?
Right now, it's more even. I'd say it's evenly distributed. We're increasing our stake in Toyota to 51. We're already 51% with Global Power direct, and 100% of property, and of course we have Metrobank at 25%. So I'd say it's starting to become more evenly distributed amongst the portfolio of component companies, and given the strong performance the previous year, we are quite comfortable moving into 2013, that will be sustained.
Okay, all right. So thank you so much for your time this morning.
Pleasure, Werner. Yeah. Thank you.
All right. Mr. Carmelo Bautista, President of GD Capital. Moving now to the foreign exchange market as of 9:56 this morning. The peso is at 40.579 against the U.S. dollar. Volume is at $148 million so far. Now over to TJ in this.